fine afternoon for baseball in Cleveland. It'll be the Tigers and the Indians. Next. Celebrating its 20th season as a Major League ballpark, a look at Progressive Field in downtown Cleveland. Ought to be a good one here. Between the defending American League champion Detroit Tigers and the Cleveland Indians. Hi again, everybody. Matt Vaskirjian here with you for this AL Central Division matchup. I'll be joined in just a minute by Eric Karros and Steve Lyons, but first, let's have a look at the starting lineup for the visiting Detroit Tigers, as Jim Leland's guys will line up this way. And getting his final warm-up tosses in, the starter who they'll be up against, as you see his totals there on the right side of your screen. Austin Jackson will step to the plate now as we're ready to get this one underway. Austin Jackson. Underway at the ballpark this afternoon as the first pitch is in there for strike one. And a pitch in the dirt as he lays off. It's 1-1. Our temperature at first pitch and even 70 degrees here this afternoon. And this ball runs away for ball two. 2-1. This is strike two called as he shakes his head. 2-2 now. Pitch runs in on him as this is fisted out to the right side of the mound. And Jackson's aboard, a base hit. So the Tigers get the leadoff man on, and with that, let's give you a look at how the Tribe stacks up defensively. It's brought to us by Majestic. Corey Hunter will get his first opportunity now. And he swings through a fastball and doesn't catch up with it. It's 0-1.
Boy, he is just wearing guys out with that two-seam fastball. I don't care if it's inside, outside, he's really hitting his spots well.
And I believe they'll say he broke the plane, as yes, he did. It's ruled a strike. Did he hold up in time? A look down, and yes, he went around. It's strike three.
That's just a nasty slider here. Way off the plate. Plays on the hitter's aggressiveness, and he gets him to go after it.
So a runner at first with one out now, and that'll bring in the ever dangerous third baseman Miguel Cabrera. They set the target in, and this finds the inside corner for strike one.
Yeah, a little surprising he didn't offer at that one. That was a dangerous spot for a good fastball hitter.
A look at Jackson, and now here it comes. Runner goes for second. Tag from Kipnis, and he's out at second base.
That's a big-time throw right there. I mean, a big-time throw. Anytime you can get this guy, you've done something.
One pitch coming now to Cabrera. Swing, and he takes this the other way to right. And he can't come up with it cleanly here in right. So problems out there in right field, as this is going to wind up going as an E9. So a runner at first with two away, and that'll bring in the slugging first baseman, Prince Fielder. Now a throw over, and the runner back safely. In the dirt, might not be enough to try it. And he'll snap one down to first, but the runner's back. Comes set, now the pitch. And Prince can't get extended here as this one's on the ground out to second. Throw on to first, and that error won't come back to haunt him after all as the inning is over. So a strong first inning of work here for Ubaldo Jimenez. It's the Tigers nothing. Now we'll look at the starting lineup for the Indians here. And getting his final warm-up tosses in, there you see the numbers for one of the very best starters in the game, All-Star right-hander Justin Verlander. Quick look now at the defensive alignment behind him for Detroit. Michael Brantley will step in now to lead things off in the home half of the first. Turns on a fastball here and sends it to fairly deep right field. And a diving effort, but he can't make the play in right. And Brantley is in there at third base. He's got himself a triple.
Well, this is all about risk-reward here. It's spectacular if you get a glove on it. If not, you got to get up off the deck and chase it down.
Jason Kipnis will dig in here. And the third baseman will have a look at it, but this is back into the seats. That's over, but low, it's a ball and a strike. Ooh, he pulls the string on the circle change, 1-2.
Wow, what a good time to take something off of that pitch, and they had him fooled pretty good on that one.
And a changeup swung on and missed for the first down.
And this is why, as a hitter, working the count in your favor is so important. I mean, here, this is probably a ball, but you can't risk taking this pitch on 1-2 and hope that you get the benefit of the umpire's call. You pretty much have to swing at it, even though you probably wouldn't have been able to do much with it in the first place.
As Drubal Cabrera will take his cuts now. Ball one. One out and a runner on third. And a good spot for that pitch is it's chopped foul. Swing and he pops him up over toward foul territory. And he'll lunge out of the crouch to make the play for out number two.
Well, anytime you get an RBI guy to the plate with less than two outs, and he does that, he is not happy. That's the kind of at-bat that'll stick with you for a while.
So a man at third here with two gone, and stepping in is the right fielder, Nick Swisher. A fastball that gets the inside corner, strike one.
Maybe they'll pitch to him after all.
He's set, now the pitch. Off-speed pitch, and this one runs in and nearly gets him here.
Yeah, I don't think this is a guy you want to mess with here. He can hurt you in more ways than one.
Two outs here with a runner at third. In there at the letters, 1-2 now.
And sometimes if you don't get to a guy like this early, then you're never going to get to him. So you don't want to let this chance pass you by.
Now the 1-2 to Swisher. And an off-speed pitch swung on and missed, and with that, the side is retired. Tribe turned away in the first. We played one in Cleveland with no score. Victor Martinez will lead things off here as it'll be 5, 6, and 7 due up to kick off the second. Swing and a high chopper. Throw to first will be in time, and there's one gone here to start the second. Andy Dirks will be the batter.
Left fielder, Andy Dirks.
And, ooh, looked pretty good on the monitor, but it's ruled a ball inside, 1-0.
We've seen that same pitch be called a strike more than once.
At third, Chisenhall. Throw to first will be in plenty of time, and Jimenez is looking sharp now. Two away.
Now, these infielders have been busy early on, and that's another ground ball out for them. Probably not going to be the last one we see either.
Johnny Peralta will stand in here, looking to keep the inning alive with two gone now in the top of the second. And he'll try to crowd him there to start the at-bat. It's 1-0. Two out, nobody on. Lays off again, and it's 2-0. And, oh man, he just can't catch a break here. It's 3-0.
I think that's consistent with how the strike zone gets called nowadays. You know, that's a strike in the rule book, but most umpires won't give you that pitch anymore.
Now the 3-0 offering. And no doubt about this one, it's in there, 3-1. And he goes with the slider here as that misses in tight. It's ball four. Alex Avila will get his first cuts here with two gone now and a runner at first. Now here's a fastball up that he sends in the air out to fairly deep center field. And as it turns out, the two-out walk doesn't come around to haunt him as that ends the inning. One left for Detroit. We'll go to the bottom of the second. No score. Carlos Santana will lead things off here as they'll have 5, 6, and 7 due up to start the home second. A swing and a miss. Took something off that one, and it's strike one.
Well, he's gotten away here early with leaving some of these pitches out over the middle of the plate, especially to start some of these at-bats.
And he'll just fight this one off as it's chopped foul. Swing and a miss on the fastball, and that's the first out.
Now he was really late on this one. I mean, really late. You can see where the baseball is by the time he gets the barrel through. I mean, it's darn near in the catcher's glove already. That tells me he was probably looking for something else.
Mark Reynolds digs in at the plate. And this one's nowhere close as that bounces to the plate for ball one. Here's a swing and a miss, 1-1. Now here it comes. And he checks his swing. Did he go around? Yes, says the first base umpire. Strike two. Strike three call, and that is back-to-back punch-outs here in the inning. Three in a row total, and there are two away.
That's just the old high hard one right there, up and out of the zone. You know, those always seem to look good coming right in there at eye level, but it's so hard to get on top of.
Yan Gomes will get his first chance now, trying to get something started with two away here in the bottom of the second. And this is taken outside for ball one. Now the pitch. Swung on and missed. 1-1. That's on the ground to short. This should end the inning. Picked up by Peralta. Throw to fielder at first will take care of him, and that'll be that. Nothing doing against Verlander that time around. It remains nothing, nothing. Omar Infante is ready to go here as we begin the third. Back at it now is Jimenez as he's able to jump ahead in the count quickly here. Nothing in one.
Wow, he is spotting that fastball on a dime here early on.
Now a swing and he just fouls this one away. Slider, good two-strike pitch, but it misses. 1-2. And a good take there. Close, but it's 2-2. And this misses from Jimenez, and that'll fill up the count now. 3-2.
Yeah, he had him in good position here. 0-2 to start the inning. You just can't seem to finish him off.
Now the fastball is right by him as he swings and misses for the first out of the inning.
If he could have been just a little more patient there, would have had a leadoff walk. Instead, chases it out of the zone here and winds up costing him.
Austin Jackson will dig in here. He singled to open up the ball game. And this is just off the outside corner for a ball, 1-0. Check swing here, but the home plate umpire says he went around, and no argument, and it's 1-1. No contact there, and it's 1-2. Now the pitch. And Jackson's not offering at that one, and it'll knot things up at 2 balls and 2 strikes. Fastball didn't miss by much, and it's a full count now, 3-2. And he just does manage to fight this one off as it's fouled away. The 3-2 one more time. And a fastball blew it right by him, and there are two down.
And obviously, any time you can strike this guy out, you'll take it. I mean, he runs like a greyhound out there. So even routine grounders can sometimes be turned into base hits. Not when you're not making contact, though.
Corey Hunter will stand in here hoping to at least put a ball in play here this inning. Now the first pitch is in the air out toward right field. And Swisher ought to have no problem with this one, and the side is retired. So a very good inning that time for Ubaldo Jimenez. Still nothing. Drew Stubbs makes his way to the plate to get us started here in the bottom of inning number three. First pitch has him dancing to avoid it. It's ball one.
If there's one thing base dealers don't like, it's when you throw at their legs. Now that's their meal ticket you're messing with.
Now a swing, and he pops him up right up the chute. This may be tough behind the plate. And Avila will make the catch there for out number one.
Sometimes when you're throwing 95 miles an hour, you can make a mistake and get away with it. Here, he just can't get on top of this one and winds up popping it up.
So one away here with the bases empty, and standing in the left-handed hitting third baseman, Lonnie Chisenhall. Lays off 1-0. And the pitch. Cabrera at third. Oh, he pulls the string on the circle change, 1-2.
I tell you, he's got a good pace. A good tempo to him out there right now.
Fouled back. To two balls and two strikes now.
Well, he watched that one all the way in, and it looked like he almost gave up on it. He's pretty lucky that wasn't called strike three.
And this ball is also hit foul and heading for the seats, so we'll have to do it again, still 2-2. No offer on that one, and Verlander's run at full now, 3-2.
Wow, what an at-bat he's having right now. He's fought off some tough pitches. He's laid off a few pitches like that one. And now he's worked his way back to a 3-2 count.
And he takes ball four. So a good job out of the nine hole in getting on base as we go back to the top of the order.
Yeah, they went to the slider there on 3-2. And that's a pitch where you're really hoping a hitter will see fastball and swing through it. But it didn't work out that time. He winds up losing him.
Michael Brantley will get a second crack at it here. Remember, he tripled to start out the home first. First pitch on its way from Verlander. Runner goes. And this is hit down the right field line, but it's going to get out of play for strike one. Now a swing and a fly ball. But this will land foul just shy of the wall. Gets a piece here as this ball is fouled away. Now a fastball here that'll wisely lay off, and it's 1-2.
A good high fastball. Maybe something to try and change the eye level there. Now I might anticipate another slider down in the zone, maybe even in the dirt.
Just one hit apiece for both of these clubs. He's ready now. The pitch. Outside and low that time. Now it's two balls and two strikes. Hit on the ground to shortstop. One there. Back to first, and a great stretch there may be the difference. It's a double play, and the inning is over. Nothing doing for the Indians there. We'll head to the fourth, still scoreless. Miguel Cabrera will stand in now to get us going here in the fourth. First pitch of the inning is taken downstairs for a ball. It's 1-0. Here it comes. And he fires in a strike this time to make it one ball and one strike. Way outside, nearly to the backstop, 2-1.
When you start that pitch off the edge, you know, most guys know well enough to lay off. You've got to start it on the edge if you want them to chase.
And a swing and a ball hit well down the left field line, but back into the crowd foul. Take him out of the zone here, and he obliges. Not the greatest of swings there for the first out. So after getting the strikeout on the fastball, not a bad time to check out our pitch speed comparison for our two starters. And whoa, look at that for a top speed. 98 miles an hour. That man is flat dealing. Prince Fielder will stand in. the American League's All-Star starter at first base a season ago. Fastball off the plate away for ball one. Now here's the pitch. Fastball misses badly there, and he's behind 2-0.
And this is all about handling a guy like this with kid gloves. You know, walk him if you have to, but don't let him be the one to beat you.
Lays off a fastball, but it's over for a strike. 2-1.
Yeah, a much better pitch there than the one he threw on 2-0.
Fielder waits the 2-1. Oh, and he turns beautifully on that fastball as this is pulled into right for a base hit.
Here's a situation where he just says, shift. What shift? I tell you, you've got to hit a ball awfully, awfully hard to get it through an alignment like that. But he's able to do it here.
Victor Martinez will stand in. He grounded out his first time. Runners on the move for second. Now Martinez gets around on one as he sends it to deep right. And that is into the right field seats. It's a home run. A two-run shot for Victor Martinez. And it's given Detroit a 2-0 lead.
And this is just a fastball right here, but I'm pretty sure it's not where he wanted it. This has got some elevation to it, and that's one of those where you know it's going to be a home run as soon as you let go of it.
Andy Dirks will stand in. He grounded out his first time. Fastball right back to the mound. And he'll just flip this on to first for the second out of the inning.
And as a pitcher, you always have to remember that once you let go of the pitch, you've got to become an infielder. Here's a guy that fields his position well, so he's in great position to spear this thing and then get the easy out at first.
Johnny Peralta will dig in. Drew a walk his first time around. Here's one hit towards the hole. And that'll be a base hit for Peralta. So now time will be called as we're going to get a visit from the pitching coach here as he'll hope to settle his guy down. Alex Avila will dig in here. He flew out his first time around. Just off the outside, and it's 1-0. And that's right there, and we're even at one. From the belt, the pitch. Might have jammed him a little there as this is softly hit and foul off to the left. And a fastball swung on and missed, and the side is retired. The The Tigers do get a couple, however, on this two-run home run. Bottom of the fourth coming up, and it's now 2-0 Tigers. Jason Kipnis will lead things off here in the home half of the fourth. First pitch on its way from Verlander. And a fastball is in there for strike one. Off the plate, one ball, one strike. Now a swing and a ball popped in the air back behind short. And there to take it in is Peralta for the first out.
Now he ran this one right in on the thumb. A great location, and it results in an easy pop-up.
As Drubal Cabrera will dig in. He popped out in foul territory his first time. First pitch to him. First pitch fastball off the plate there, and it's ball one. And he watches a called strike as this one bears in on him. 1-1. Line hard, but foul. Ball two. No offer on that one, and Verlander's run at full now, 3-2.
Well, that's an opportunity wasted on the mound there. A hitter's got to be defensive on 2-2, but that was so far outside, he didn't even have to worry about chasing it.
Swing and a miss on the changeup, and there are two gone.
And we'll get a good look at the grip on this last circle change. You can see that your fingers actually make kind of an okay symbol on the side of the baseball, and that gives it that nice fading movement it has at the end.
Nick Swisher will try it again, set down on strikes his first time. And there's a fastball from Verlander to jump ahead 0-1. Bounty breaks off a beauty there, nothing in two now.
Yeah, he has been patient up there, but now he's backed himself into a corner.
No runs, just one hit, and one error in the ballgame for Cleveland so far. Struck him out, so he set down on strikes for the second time today. Nothing across here this half of the inning. We played four full. The Tigers lead it 2-0. Omar Infante will make his way towards the box to lead off the fifth. Here's the first offering. And he takes a pitch that's ruled a strike at the knees. Pretty liberal strike zone there. It's 0-1. Lays off the slider, and it's 1-1.
And he's tracking that all the way across the plate, but that had too much sweep to it for him to think of swinging.
Right there at the belt, 1-2 now.
He showed him that slider running away two times in a row. Now might be a good time to call in that two-seamer running in.
Jimenez deals the 1-2. And a slider runs away from him there, and the count levels at 2-2. He took a big swing there as he lifts a high pop-up, drifting into foul territory at first. And in front of the screen, he'll look it into the glove for the first out of the inning.
Well, that'll be a frustrating at-bat for him. Now, he's got to be thinking he let one get away there because, you know, that's a pitch he should have been able to handle.
One out now here in the Tiger fifth inning. And we'll go back to the top of the order now for Austin Jackson. Third baseman in tight, protecting the bunt the first pitch. Fastball misses in the dirt as he tried to get him to chase the low one. Two and oh. Bases are empty, one man out. And a fastball in the dirt that's taken for a ball. Even have to take the bat off its moorings. A four-pitch walk here. Corey Hunter will stand in. He flew out his last time up. And this is on the ground to short. Could be two. Barehanded for one. On to first as they get the double play to get him out of the inning. Tigers fail to make any noise. They're up 2-0. Back alongside Eric Karros and Steve Lyons, Matt Vasgersian, as Carlos Santana will settle in to lead things off here for Cleveland. Grounded foul toward the third base dugout. One and one. Outside, 2-1. And this one is over, and he works the count back to 2-2. Full count, 3-2. Here's a swing and a high pop up. Drifting into foul territory now toward the third base dugout. And Avila will make the catch there for out number one. There's our line score through the first 4.5. And these guys have basically had the bats taken right out of their hands. Just one hit to this point. Mark Reynolds will get another shot. Called out on strikes his first time around. Now here's a ball hit hard on the ground towards short. And now this ties up Peralta.
Didn't look like there was anything too special about this ground ball. Just looked like he maybe raised his head a little bit there. And that'll cost him a one-out base runner.
Yan Gomes will stand in. He grounded out his first time. And he lays off there, 1-0. I had him guessing that time as he's barely able to foul it away. Runner at first here, one man out. And just lucky to make contact on that one as it's chopped foul. Misses, ball two. And here's a changeup in there for a called third strike, and that's the second out of the inning.
And after the error on that previous play, I think he's out there saying, you know what, why don't I just take care of this guy myself? Good job out there to bounce back with the strikeout.
Drew Stubbs will dig in. He popped out in foul territory his first time. Here's the first pitch to him. First pitch here misses wide, 1-0.
That's what you have to do against a big sweeping slider like that. It starts in the zone, and it's probably going to finish out of the zone, so that's a good job just to lay off.
This now is hit to second. Does he have another 1-2-3 inning? He does. Eight in a row he's set down, and the side is retired. So put another zero on the board as they've been held scoreless through five. Five innings complete. Detroit is out in front, 2-0. Miguel Cabrera will get things started here in the top of inning number six. And with Prince Fielder lurking, we'll see a left-hander get up in the bullpen. Back at it now is Jimenez as he's able to jump ahead in the count quickly here. Nothing and one. Outside for a ball, 1-1. Hit the target, but this is low, 2-1. And he's fallen behind now, 3-1.
Yeah, a 3-1 count now to a guy that just won the Triple Crown. That's bad enough, but he's got protection behind him in Fielder here, too.
And this is fouled back and out of play. Full count pitch on its way. Tough pitch to lay off, but he did, and it's ball four, so the leadoff hitter is aboard to start the sixth.
Hey, you know what? That's all right. He gave him a pretty good battle up there, and he never gave in to him. A walk you can work around. A home run, you can't.
Now here comes the Cleveland skipper up out of the dugout on his way to the mound. And that is going to be all this afternoon for Ubaldo Jimenez. He'll wind up lasting just five innings here. Didn't pitch all that poorly, yet he's gone nonetheless. Nick Hagedon will take over on the mound now here in the sixth inning. Prince Fielder will be the first to stand in against the new pitcher as he'll do so with a runner at first and nobody out. Now a fastball a bit too low here. It's ball one. Two runs, four hits, one error for the Tigers thus far. There goes Cabrera. Fastball right back to the mound. To Cabrera for one on the first, so he comes right out of the bullpen and gets the double play.
Boy, right there, with the runner moving on that play, he didn't even think they were going to try to get it out at second base. But somehow, they still managed to turn over the double play.
Victor Martinez will stand in again as we flash you back here to the fourth inning. This was a two-run home run that was definitely one of the big blows of the ball game to this point. And this ball is lined into right field, and he's got himself his second hit of the afternoon. And this will find the wall out near the visitor's bullpen. And he is safe at second base as he legs out a double.
And the way their starter's throwing, another run here, that might be all they need. He's into scoring position now with a double.
Andy Dirks will get an opportunity here in a run-scoring spot now following the two-out double. And ball four here on the intentional walk, so now they'll have a force at any base with two gone. Johnny Peralta will dig in. He singled his last time around. And he'll start him with a high strike here on the fastball on the outside corner. It's 0-1.
Yeah, even with two on and two away, this is not a guy that's going to back down out there. He comes right after him with a fastball, and he gets ahead.
Good swing there by Peralta, but he comes up empty, 0-2.
And on the mound, you can tell he's not in here to mess around. He means business.
Two down, runners at first and second. From the stretch, rolled softly down the line, and that is a foul ball. Swing and a line drive to center field. And that's in there. Base hit. And the run will score from second here as this is now a 3-0 game.
Oh, just a great approach there to get him an RBI on the base hit. And with the way their guys throwing the ball, three runs might be enough to do it.
Alex Avila will stand in now. He flew out in his first time around and then was a strikeout victim last time. Now here's the first pitch. And this is low, ball one. That's by him for strike one. Two men are on with two men out. Getting a few steps off a second there. Now the pitch. Fastball called strike, 1-2. And tough fastball to lay off on 1-2, but he did, and it's 2-2 now. Grounded to third. On to Kipnis at second, and the inning is over. Tigers get just the one. 9-1-2 scheduled to hit in the home half of the sixth. Tigers lead this one 3-0. Lonnie Chisenhall will be the batter as we get things going in the bottom of the sixth. He'll start him with a breaking ball. Too low that time. It's ball one. Some action now in the Tigers' bullpen as they'll get a left-hander and a right-hander up to throw. And this is going to find the crowd down the left field line. It's a ball and a strike. Looked like he was on that one, but it's 1-2. Just does manage to get a piece there as this is bounced foul. He'll try again, 1-2. Trying to pick up that outside corner, but this misses, and it's back to even at 2 balls and 2 strikes. Full count as that misses. It's 3-2 now. Swing and ooh, he saws him off with that one. And he'll steer clear of the flying debris to make the catch here for the first down. Michael Brantley will get another shot. He hit into a double play his last time. In there for strike one. And this will be fouled away. O2 is a fastball that misses inside. 1-2 now.
Well, I think that fastball is just for show there. He's not trying to throw this for a strike.
And a fastball. Tough take there, but it's even back at 2-2. Verlander starting to run up his pitch count. He's at 75 thus far. Got him. And that's 8 strikeouts now for him in the ballgame.
And I'll tell you what, a 3-0 lead with the way this guy's throwing must look like a 10-0 lead to these guys. I mean, they just haven't been able to solve him at all so far.
Jason Kipnis will stand in now. He struck out and flied out 0 for 2 thus far. And this one's not close. It's in the dirt for ball one. Changes up on him, but that's in the dirt for the ball.
Yeah, and he didn't even have to think twice about that one. And now he's got a good hitter's count here, 2-0.
On the way. Ball hit high to the right side. But this will get into the seats, foul. hits softly to the right side. And an underhanded throw is in time for out number three. So another good inning for him on the mound. Six shutout innings now. Seventh inning coming up. Tigers are out in front, 3-0. Back here in Cleveland, we're through the first six innings with the Tigers on top, and before we start the seventh, let's take a look at our game summary. Matt Albers is on to pitch now as he'll take over to start inning number seven. Omar Infante will stand in. He struck out and popped out in two trips. And he gets ahead 0-1. Now some movement in the Tribe bullpen as a right-hander starts to loosen up. Right there, and it's quickly 0-2 now.
Yeah, that's a different pitch here, but also on the outside corner. Also taken for a strike. So he's got him in a quick 0-2 hole now.
And now a pitch on the way. And this is a swing and a miss on a ball in the dirt as they'll need to throw down to first. Throw on to first is in time to get him. So that'll go down as a strikeout and a 2-3 putout for out number one. Austin Jackson will stand in, base on balls his last time. First pitch is a sinker for a called strike one.
Oh, and you wonder if maybe he decided beforehand just to take a pitch up there first. Too bad for him because that thing was right down Broadway.
And a sinker's in there for a called strike, and he forges ahead, nothing in two. Oh, and he dusted him off the plate that time. Some mind games being played now. It's 1-2.
And even on 0-2, you don't want guys to get into a comfort level up there.
Now a swing and a high fly ball, and this one has some carry on it to deep right field. And Swisher will gather this one in for route number two.
Yeah, just a little bit late here on the fastball, and this thing's almost by him when he makes contact. Still, he gets pretty good wood on the ball, but not enough to trouble the right fielder.
Corey Hunter will get another shot. He hit into a double play his last time. First pitch coming. Now a ball lined toward right center, and Torrey has himself a base hit.
Sometimes when you're aggressively minded at the plate, you don't always have to get a strike to hit the ball hard. I mean, I don't think this pitch is even in the strike zone, but he still manages to square it up well and drive it for a base hit.
Miguel Cabrera will stand in, base on balls his last time. First offering on the way. And a high strike there, 0-1. A runner on first with two away. And this catches the zone as well. It's 0-2 now.
No taking now. He's going to have to swing the bat.
And a sinker there, swung on and missed for out number three. Tigers leave one, but they're on top by a count of 3-0. As Drubal Cabrera come forward now, he's popped out and struck out in his first two plate appearances. Now he'll try to bunt his way on, but this is popped up. Verlander is there, and he makes the catch for the out.
When we get a look there at his pitches by inning, he's at 81 now after that last pitch, so he should be good for a little while longer.
Nick Swisher will stand in, and he, like so many others, hitless in the ballgame so far. Some action out in the bullpen, couple of right-handers starting to loosen up. And a changeup here misses off the corner to start him out. It's ball one.
Well, we've talked about all the strikeouts. The only side effect is right there, though. He's run up a pretty high pitch count now.
Swisher waiting. Here's the 1-0 pitch. Fastball, and that thing got up there at 95 miles an hour, a ball and a strike. Fastball that just misses here as the count moves to 2-1. Just got a piece of it as it's fouled back. Now the 2-2 pitch. Just does stay alive as this is fouled back. Look out. Don't want to hit him there. It's full 3-2.
And this late into his afternoon of work, the longer this at-bat goes, the better chance that he might slip up and leave one out over the middle of the plate.
Now a swing, and he just fouls this one away. Payoff pitch one more time. Ball blasted out to straightaway central. This has plenty of carry on it, and it's going to carry over the wall, a home run. So it's a solo home run by Nick Swisher, and the Indians are now on the board. It's a 3-1 ball game.
Even though this is only one run, this is important, not just because it gets them on the board, but also because they needed something to get the dugout going a bit. Give them some life.
Carlos Santana will step in now, 0-2 to this point. Gets under this one just a bit as it'll be a chance for Jackson in center. Two gone. Mark Reynolds will stand in 0-2 in the ballgame so far. Verlander's pitch is hit right past him on the mound and into center field for a base hit.
And this guy's had his way with him so far, so maybe this is the way to change things up. Maybe go into attack mode up there. Kind of get the sense that they've been a little too passive, so this is a nice first pitch single.
Yan Gomes will try it again. He's grounded out and struck out in two trips. Some action now in the Tigers' bullpen as they'll get a left-hander and a right-hander up to throw. Called strike at the letters, 0-1. And there's a fastball that's hammered the other way to deep right field. A leap, but he can't bring it back into the park. It's a home run. A two-run blast to straightaway right field, and the Indians have come back to tie things at three.
Things are starting to really go their way now. This is the second home run they've hit here in this inning, and they've worked things back to even. So the momentum, it's definitely shifted dugouts.
Bruce Stubbs will dig in for a third time now. He's popped out and grounded out so far. Grounded foul off to the right and over toward the dugout. And that misses downstairs for a ball, 1-1. Line hard deep into left. Dirk is going to have room out there as he puts this away to retire the side. So two home runs in the inning lead to three runs on the scoreboard. We'll look ahead to inning number eight now, and we are all tied at three apiece. Prince Fielder will get us going now in the top half of the eighth. And a first pitch slider is right there for strike one.
Getting that first pitch strike is so important against a guy like this. You have to be able to work ahead in the count and not let him dictate the at-bat.
And now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there. Off the plate and in, it's a ball and a strike. Now here it comes. Swung on and missed. 1-2 now.
Yeah, that's a very hittable location right there. Not where you want to be when you're facing a guy like this.
Look out. That one almost got away from him. 2-2 now. pitch on the way. And a tough pitch on two strikes as he's able to foul it off. Swing and a little tapper out in front of the mound. On to first, and that's an important first out to start the eighth here. Time to bring you up to date on the numbers for our two starters. It's our starter comparison, and the hometown nine have had trouble generating much by way of hits, as you can see by the left side of your screen. Victor Martinez will dig in. He homered back in the fourth. First pitch here is a sinker that runs a bit too wide. It's ball one. And this is fought off at the plate as it's chopped foul. And a sinker sinks too much there as it bounces into the catcher's glove.
Yeah, and on 2-1 right now, you gotta figure this guy's wound up for the fastball here. Maybe you come with the breaking ball here out of the zone and hope he goes after it.
Two-one pitch as a sinker swung on and missed. 2-2. Third, Chisenhall. Throw on to first gets Martinez, and that's the second out of the inning.
This is exactly what he needed after his guys came back to tie the ball game. He's only one out away from a shutdown inning.
Andy Dirks will step in, and we'll see if they decide to pitch to him this time around. Starts him out with a fastball too low for ball one.
And if there's one guy on this roster that wants the ball in a moment like this, this is the guy.
In for a strike, it's 1-1. Had him off stride that time, and it's 1-2. The pitch. And now a slider in on the hands, and he's lucky that one didn't come and get him.
You don't want guys to get too comfortable up there, so that's a good idea to run something in tight.
And this will miss down low in the dirt, so he's worked it full now at 3-2. Now here's the pitch. Just did get a piece of that one, so he stays alive here. On a big swing as he takes this one to the opposite field. High and deep to left center. And a long run, but he's there to track it down. Nice range, and the side is retired. Down in order go the Tigers. Score remains tied at 3-3. Dwayne Velo is on out of the bullpen now as he'll take over to start the bottom of the eighth. Lonnie Chisenhall will lead things off here in the bottom half of inning number eight. First pitch misses here to the leadoff man in the inning. The number nine hitter in the lineup, it's ball one. And now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there. And he falls behind now, 2-0. Ball hit high down the left field line, but back in amongst the spectators, foul. Trying to shave that outside corner with the fastball, and he missed it. It's 3-1 now. He just gets a piece there as this is chopped foul. Oh, right back to him on the mound. And he'll flip on to first to record the out. Michael Brantley will dig in. Strikeout victim his last time. And he gets a piece of this one to foul it toward the backstop. Now here's the pitch. And this misses the outside corner, so it's knotted up at 1-1. Right back to the outside part of the plate, but that misses as well. It's 2-1. Just off the inside part of the plate, it's 3-1. And, oh, that should have been ball four there, but it's a called strike, and that runs things full at 3-2.
That's a borderline strike right there. And I think that he had one step out of the batter's box headed towards first already.
One out, nobody on. And he lays off, ball four. Now the potential go-ahead run is on base here.
That's an easy take right there on the 3-2 pitch. Not all that inviting at all. You want to at least make the guy think about hacking up there. Instead, now he's on with one away.
Jason Kipnis will try again. 0-3 thus far. Now a fastball a bit too low here. It's ball one. And he looks at a changeup in there, 1-1. Ground is short. Could this be two? Oh, and he can't come up with it. And the throw will be too late as he can't recover in time. So that'll go into the books as an E6, and he'll be kicking himself over that one. As Drubal Cabrera will stand in now. He's been kept quiet out of the number three hole, hitless in his three at-bats so far. And he gets ahead here with the fastball, strike one. Breaking pitch, and this bounces in front of the catcher. Try to go away with this one, but it misses as well, and it's to 2-1 now.
Whoa, that one definitely took off on him right there. He's lucky that thing didn't go all the way to the backstop.
Runners are at first and second with one away. Hit hard on the ground is short, and that's through into left, a base hit. The throw to the plate. But it is not in time as they take the lead here in the late going. Octavio Dotel will get the call now as he'll try to get the final two outs here and get this one on to the ninth inning. Nick Swisher will be the first one to greet him here as he'll be forced to turn around and hit from the left side now. And it looks like a right-hander's got enough to throw in the Tiger bullpen. They set the target in, and this finds the inside corner for strike one. Good leadoff a second there. Now the pitch. Inside with the slider, and that'll back him up a bit. And he'll try to hold back the swing, but he'll do so unsuccessfully as that's ruled a strike. Now a spin and a throwback to second, and a dive, but he's back in. Now the 1-2 to Swisher. Now he turns on one and rips it down the line. But this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at 1-2. Now a cutter down around his shoe tops as he hops out of the way. The 2-2 coming. Now here's a fastball up that he sends in the air out to fairly deep center field. Runner tags from second as the catch is made here shy of the track. And they won't get him at third. They're runners at the corners here with two gone. Carlos Santana will stand in. He flew out his last time up. Thank you. And this is on the ground toward the hole. And the throw to first is in time, but the damage has been done as the side is retired. Indians forced to settle for one. We've played eight full. The Tribe lead this one 4-3. Ninth inning save situation in front of us, and they'll ask the right-hander Chris Perez to get the final three outs. Johnny Peralta will lead things off here in the ninth against the closer Perez. Now some movement in the Tribe bullpen as a right-hander starts to loosen up. Ninth inning underway as the first pitch misses for ball one. The next pitch. Now a swing and a hard hit ball to short. Throw on to first for the out, and that is how the ninth inning gets underway.
Well, this is what you want out of your closer. Comes in firing darts, and it's a very quick out number one.
Alex Avila will try again, 0-for-3 thus far. Now here's the first pitch. And here's a swing, and another chance out there is short. Taken there by Cabrera. Throw on to first will be in time, and now the Tigers are down to their final out.
Well, that's just good pitching right there. Really ties him up with that fastball in on the hands. And he hits just a simple ground ball there for the easy out.
Omar Infante will try and turn it around. 0-for-3 with a couple of strikeouts thus far. First pitch coming. Hard hit to third. Throw in time, and the ball game is over.
Yeah, you know that run in the bottom of the eighth turned out to be the difference maker. They're able to hold on here and get this win in a squeaker.
A tight ball game all throughout. Winds up a slim one-run victory in the end as we get you one final look at our line score. Tightly contested ball game here, so it makes it hard to find our top player of the game, but I think this fella right here would seem to be the logical choice.
Yeah, he only had one hit, but he definitely made it count. A big home run that turned out to be the decisive blow in the ball game.
So that'll just about do it. For Eric Harrow, Steve Lyons, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. This has been a presentation of MLB 13, The Show. For more, check out theshownation.com. The Indians win this one 4-3. So long from Cleveland.